Plant pathology is the study of plant diseases. Diseases are caused by microorganisms such as fungi, bacteria, and viruses. Some disease symptoms, such as leaf spots and wilting, are easily seen or measured. Others are difficult to observe or are very subtle. Detecting the less obvious symptoms is more difficult when the diseased plant is the only specimen of its kind in the landscape and cannot be compared with a healthy one. Normally, non-parasitic plant disorders are not included in the study of diseases, but it's still important to recognize them. These disorders include improper planting depth, nutrient imbalances, temperature extremes, toxic chemicals, mechanical injury, water imbalances, and air pollution. Most environmentally induced problems tend to be uniform, whereas disease may show up in spots throughout a site. I'm Dr. DeBusk, and this video will review the types of pathogens and abiotic disorders for ornamental plants. To diagnose plant diseases effectively, it is necessary to understand the biology of the microorganisms that cause them: fungi, bacteria, and viruses. Three conditions are required for a disease to develop in plants: an organism that causes disease, a host plant susceptible to the pathogen, and an environment conducive to disease development, such as a particular temperature, wet plant surface, or overly wet soil. These three conditions, commonly known as the plant disease triangle, must all exist at the same time and in the same place. When the three conditions above occur at the same time, the pathogen infects the susceptible host and the disease starts. Disease continues until a change in the environment works against the pathogen. About 85% of plant diseases are caused by fungi, multi-celled microorganisms that may be seen without a microscope during certain stages of their life cycles. Fungi have no chlorophyll and their cell walls are composed of chitin and other polysaccharides instead of cellulose, which composes plant cell walls. Many species of fungi can be identified by the microscopic spores they produce, reproductive structures that aid in dispersal and survival. Some fungi develop masses of hyphae, collectively referred to as mycelia, and spores that are readily visible. Some fungi have no spores, such as rhizoctonia, which can be identified microscopically by the very characteristic right-angle branches of its fungal threads, hyphae. With pathogens, you can see signs and/or symptoms. A symptom is the physiological changes to the plant as a result of the disease. For fungi, this may be wilt, chlorosis, or yellowing, stunting, leaf spots, or blights. A sign is the physical evidence of the pathogen. This can include spores such as rust or powdery mildew spores, mycelium, sclerotia, which is a hard resting spore, mushrooms, and conks. Wind often disperses many fungal pathogens. Spores can be carried for miles by wind. Splashing water from rainfall or irrigation will also move fungal spores from plant to plant. Fungi that live in the soil can move from plant to plant by growing along intermingled roots or out from infested plant debris in the soil. Some fungi, such as rhizoctonia, can survive on their own for long periods of time without a host by living in plant debris or soil. Fungi can also be spread by human activity through movement of already diseased plants or through the use of gardening tools. While fungi may enter a plant through its natural openings or through wounds, they can also penetrate directly through the plant's cuticle. Bacteria are one-celled organisms that are so small they can only be seen with a powerful light microscope. Most plant pathogenic bacteria do not produce spores. Although some bacteria can survive in the soil and decaying plant material for a time, they usually need a host to survive. Bacteria are dependent on outside agents for dispersal from plant to plant. Splashing water is the chief means by which bacteria are disseminated. Another important means of dispersal is through human contact. Many bacterial diseases can be spread simply through the process of touching an infected plant and then touching a healthy plant with hands or pruning tools. Bacteria cannot penetrate the cuticle of plants, but must enter the plant through a wound or natural opening to initiate disease. A special subgroup of bacteria called phytoplasmas require an insect host for dispersal and entry into the plant. Pseudomonas and Xanthomonas are common bacterial organisms that cause disease in plants. Bacterial diseases can be divided into two types, systemic and localized. Systemic bacterial diseases can invade plant tissues that carry water and nutrients. Then the disease spreads throughout all parts of the plant, like southern bacterial wilt of tomato. Under certain conditions, the bacterial pathogen may grow in only one area of the infected plant. This localized infection can cause stem rots, leaf spots and blights, wilts, and root rots. Bacterial diseases often produce water soaking around the area where the bacteria enter the leaf. Later, the lower surface of the leaf has a dark and greasy appearance. You most often see the greasy appearance in leaf infections. These are common symptoms of a bacterial disease. But you also need to look for signs of the pathogen, such as bacterial ooze as it transpires from a lesion. You can see ooze most often in the morning. Some bacterial diseases have strong odors. Other symptoms are listed here and include galls, cankers, wilt, and soft decay. Many of these symptoms are the same as those that fungi cause. This can make identifying a disease and what caused it challenging unless you send a plant sample to a diagnostic lab. Sometimes you can distinguish the difference between leaf diseases that bacteria and fungi cause by the location and appearance of the spots. Spots that bacteria cause often are along the margins of the leaf or adjacent to leaf veins. The spots sometimes have angular corners caused by the proximity of the leaf veins around the spots. Early in the morning or after heavy watering or rain, the margins of bacterial spots have a water-soaked appearance. This wet appearance is ooze emerging from the stem or leaf lesions. When the leaf is dry, the ooze dries and appears as a shiny thin flake. Check for bacterial streaming to determine if bacteria are causing wilt. Make a horizontal cut in a stem and place it in a jar of water. If bacteria are present, a cloudy stream will emit from the cut in the stem within a few minutes. Millions of bacteria compose this stream. Viruses are the smallest of the three pathogens described here and can only be seen with an electron microscope. They are made up of genetic material, which is usually wrapped in a protein coat. They must have a living host in order to reproduce because they use plant host cells in the reproduction process. Most fungi and bacteria reproduce independent of the plant host. Viruses are usually spread from disease to healthy plants by insects, but can also be spread by mites, nematodes, fungi, and even humans. The organism spreading the virus is referred to as a vector. In Florida, although most viruses are vectored by insects, primarily aphids or whiteflies, viruses can also gain entry into plants through openings made during pruning and grafting and from equipment injury. Viral diseases are recognized by the symptoms on the plant. Symptoms depend on the type of virus, the type of plant, and environmental conditions. Viral disease symptoms include curling leaves, stunted plants, wilting, mosaic patterns of spots on leaves and fruit, misshaped leaves, and chlorotic leaves. Abiotic literally means without life. Abiotic plant disorders are non-biological factors usually associated with the plant's environment that affects plants adversely. These environmental factors include extreme temperatures, strong winds, too much or too little moisture, high or low soil pH, poor air quality, too much or too little light, and nutritional problems. If one or more of these factors goes above or below the optimum range for a given plant species, plant growth might be abnormal or adversely affected. Abiotic disorders may also be caused by human activities such as pesticide and fertilizer applications. Pests are more likely to infect plants that have the following stresses. Nutrients. The low organic, highly porous soils in Florida do not hold high level of nutrients. Many Florida soils have the added problem of an alkaline pH. Because of this alkaline pH, some essential nutrients are often not available for plant roots to take up. Too much water. After an abundance of rain, plant roots may not be able to absorb oxygen because water fills the space that usually holds air. Feeder roots die, which can damage the plant. This problem can occur in compacted soils too. Soil fungi that cause root disease may easily infect a plant's roots. Light and temperature problems. Plants can get sunburned from dramatic fluctuations in the amount of light after tree branches or entire trees are removed. A rapid drop in temperature close to or below freezing kills soft herbaceous plant tissue. Cold temperatures can damage tender new growth, branches, stems, and trunks of woody plants. Not enough water. Plants will often wilt and leaves will scorch when temperatures are high and the soil is deficient in moisture. New leaves on plants that do not obtain enough water will show leaf scorch. This is especially true when plants are in bright light and drying winds. Recognizing the causes of these stresses and eliminating them helps protect plants from diseases caused by plant pathogens. Be careful when you use lawn mowers, line trimmers, and other edging equipment around woody plants, as this equipment can cause wounding. These plants are more likely to be injured if they do not have any mulch around their base. since mulch helps prevent the equipment from contact. Woody plants along driveways and parking areas can be injured by the repeated opening of vehicle doors against them or by the bumper hitting them. These injuries cause stress and can provide openings for plant pathogens and other pests. Hopefully you learned more about fungi, bacteria, and viruses, as well as the various abiotic disorders that can occur in ornamental plants.